guys, I just got a new phone, and am I liking it? Yeah. Is it easy to record on? No. This is my first video in 3 weeks. I think in 3 weeks. I've been doing business on getting another 140. That's right here. Here's the one. The other one's coming tomorrow. I have 4 tractors, including the one that's coming tomorrow. And holy cow, it's a lot of grass. I do not need to pick up with my drag, which may not be a good idea to pick up, because then I have to go get off, pick up the drag, and do all that horse crap. I don't need that horse crap right now, because I just picked up my phone, and it's kind of hard to pick up the drag and keep the tractor moving at the same time. Well, I did figure out how to get that blade to work from the 110, and you never know, I kind of broke my selfie cam already, so I need to trade my phone back in again. Someone did not know how to keep it out of his pocket, like me. Ah, crap! Don't stall out, tractor. Okay, that hurts. Sorry about that. That kind of sucked. Sorry, raspberry bushes. I can't edit this out, so holy flip, I should say. I won't say the other one because of holy. Sorry about that little mistake. I just couldn't get the tractor to turn right because I got my drag offset. The only reason why I got it offset is it looked like it was pulling nicer, and the tractor would pull it nicer, even with this little rattle. Which, it ain't a bad tractor. I don't have any major troubles with it. It hasn't let me down. It don't quit. And it kind of does a nice job. Just tomorrow I'm getting a running 140 H1. If you know what that is. If you don't, it's just a 140 with one hydraulic lever, the main one, with a mower deck in the 3-point. And it does actually have, it did come with the mower deck, but I couldn't convince him to trade that with a little dirt bike, which I'll get a good shot of that up here. Maybe I can speed it up without stalling the tractor out. Ooh, crap, she's not liking it. Ain't liking it, but it's working. Let me see if I can get a good shot up before I turn around. That little bike over there traded me a 140 H1 for it. But I'm gonna be nice and power wash it for him. Ah, oh, crap, the tractor's moving. Come on. Which, isn't it funny how you see an old friend and you just haven't seen him for a long time? And you see him at a restaurant? It's kind of funny. That already happened to me. I won't tell you her name, but she was a nice looking girl. And you see, as I keep going through, it levels it all out. Then I'll go through here with a sprayer and a roller. But we already got rain coming. Like, we already did 3 hours ago. We got like a centimeter of rain in my book, but it was coming down hard. I mean, holy cow, hard. This is all I'm doing. But you might say this is boring. do I can? No. I have 4 tractors now. And my dad's already mad because I did this deal behind his back. The guy's coming tomorrow. It's just kind of hard to concentrate doing this. Holy cow. I got too much stuff on my mind. And Mountain Dew will help that. Which, if you're wondering what I'm doing, just comment and I'll get more of this with the other track. The new addition that will be coming to model. Which I will show you a bit more of it. This is just slow work. I don't think I need to even spray this. I really don't want to. That's just too much work. See? It's been tree day. We've been taking out limbs and trees and everything else when I've been working on everything. Yeah, my back hurts. I've been doing too much crazy stuff with the 112. Which, did I post that video about the 112? Oh no, my 112 patio. One bad little tractor, I know that. Did nice. That's hooking hard. Wow. I've been trying to find parts for an Yamaha IT465. And that's pretty hard. This tractor's pretty quiet without the straight pipe. I'm not liking it. And I've had this one for almost 3 weeks. It took me a week to get it running. I used it for a whole last week. I've used it almost all this week, and this is a Saturday. And I have put expensive hydraulic oil in it. We bought a 5-gallon pail. Oh my gosh. This thing hasn't used a drop of what I put in it. I check it every time I use it. I run it really hard, but I can't beat the heck out of the engine or I'll blow it up. It's kind of sensitive right now. Before I put the rod bearings in it, I'm going to bore it out probably 40 thousandths. Or whatever I can get. If it's 10 thousandths or 15 thousandths, I really don't care. It just needs to have a little more giddy up and go. And sorry about all the camera movement and stuff like that. Like that. I've just been going through trees, tree limbs, trying not to get the camera scratched. I scratched the camera. I don't think you'll like this phone for the next 2 years. Because I've already broke the selfie cam and I might have to go turn it back in. Which that might make you a little more happier. This tractor needs to get power washed badly. If someone wouldn't have broke my power washer, I would have been more happier. Which the tow-off, John Deere 140, H1, H2, and H3, is only from the hydraulic levers. I'm going to get the H1, and I'm looking for the H2. I found an H2, but he don't want to get rid of it right at the moment. At the moment, he don't want to get rid of it, but I found the 120, but it's the special edition, the patio version. And he's out of my price range. Or out of my trade range, I should say.
Okay.
Come with that. I'll be back for that later. This one is one lugging old tractor. I get the 4020 back down here because the owner already blew the front tire out on it. It's the neighbor's, but he lets me call it mine. Because I put $3,000 into it. Fixed the injection pump, new injectors, and there's a lot more. And I'm gonna get out of here. I'll see you.